Hi everyone, this is Dr. Fox. Let's talk about the thorax. In this video, we'll discuss the osteological and muscular boundaries of the thorax, and also the divisions and the major contents of the thoracic cavity. So let's start with the bones. The thorax is probably best conceptualized as a bony cage. There are 12 thoracic vertebrae from T1 to T12, and each of these vertebrae is associated with a pair of ribs, or costae. 10 of the 12 ribs are going to connect along the medial border to a sternum via costal cartilages. This is hyaline cartilage. Between these ribs are intercostal spaces, and the intercostal spaces are comprised of three major layers of muscle: external, internal, and innermost intercostal, as well as the neurovasculature that serves these muscles. Now, two of the 10 ribs are known as floating ribs because they typically do not connect to the sternum. And we'll discuss these more when we discuss the kidneys. Now, if we look along the anteroinferior border of the rib cage, we have a cartilaginous margin called the costal margin or costal arch. This is the inferior most osteological feature of the anterolateral rib cage. And it's along this margin, anterolaterally, that the diaphragm is going to connect. That diaphragm is a muscular division between the thoracic cavity superiorly and the abdominal pelvic cavity inferiorly. Now let's take a closer look at the sternum. The sternum is going to overlay the mediastinum, which is going to be a central feature of the thoracic cavity, as we'll see. And there are important viscera in the mediastinum, such as the heart. The sternum is tripartite. There's a manubrium, a body, and a xiphoid process. The manubrium is the most superior element of the sternum, and at its superior edge, there's a jugular notch. You can go ahead and palpate that jugular notch. And along its inferior border, it creates a sternal angle with the body. This sternal angle, sometimes called the angle of Lewis, is what sets the anterior border for the thoracic plane. So if we were to imagine moving posteriorly from this sternal angle back to the intervertebral disc of T4, T5, that will be the thoracic plane. It's also here at this sternal angle that the second ribs are going to attach via their costal cartilages. Now let's take a deeper look at the thoracic cavity. So there are three spaces within the thoracic cavity. There are paired pulmonary cavities laterally. These pulmonary cavities are going to contain the lungs and the serosal membranes that encase the lungs, called the pleurae. The pleurae are a double membrane. So there is a parietal part which will adhere to the external walls and floors and medial contents. And then there's a visceral part that adheres directly to the lungs themselves. And then there will be a pleural cavity in between the parietal and visceral part. Medial to these pulmonary cavities is an area called the mediastinum. That mediastinum is the central element of the thoracic cavity. It's going to contain a lot of key viscera, such as the heart within the pericardium, the great vessels that are delivering blood to and from the heart, the thymus gland, various neurovasculature throughout. And this will be a focus of some of our subsequent sessions. So we've discussed the bony thorax and some of the muscular portions of the walls and floor of the thorax. We've talked about the features of the osteology. We've discussed the thoracic cavity and its divisions, the pulmonary cavities and the mediastinum and their major contents. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.